Good evening. There are major flood alerts across the far north tonight after ex-tropical cyclone Jasper dumped up to half a metre of rain on the region. Rivers and creeks have swelled, spilling into suburbs and forcing dozens of residents to flee. In the dead of night,
hello,
rescue crews go from door to door.
What we're going to do is we're going to encourage you to evacuate. It's quite deep down this end and there's no indication of it going down.
One by one, men, women, children and family pets are helped out of their homes to higher ground.
Now it gets quite deep, so hold your stuff up, OK? I'll help you. You'll feel the dip. There you go.
Braving that's cool water, right, which broke the banks of the Mossman River.
House is going under. Beautiful far north Queensland, eh?
The Fear family was fearless.
Able getting rescued, man, by the SES.
Mum, dad and five kids packed what they could and left their home behind.
So we're on the water. Got to get out.
Right, we just got to get everything we possibly can upstairs.
We're going to have to gut the whole bottom half of this house now.
Now staying in a caravan to repair and rebuild, their belongings waterlogged.
You know, you hear about it. But actually seeing it is totally different, how quick that water comes in.
We've got about 120 mil coming in the next hour. In the 11 years I've been here, I've never seen this happen.
I've got a knock on my door, fireys, police, evacuation, no choice.
I think most of the people in Mossman Street were all vast asleep at 3 in the morning and next minute bang, 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 and you know, the fire brigade came along and said, time to evacuate.
Torrential rain submerging Mossman Street and houses.
Under the house is completely gone. Bedroom, fridge.
The water did rise significantly faster than they believed it would.
We're not going to get that car. We might be able to get that one out.
Many residents were completely caught out, others surprised by these rising waters. They say it crept up slowly overnight and then suddenly they had to take action.
How are you feeling?
A bit anxious. Yeah.
Residents and crews worried not only about the rain, but local wildlife.
There has been multiple recorded sightings of large crocodiles in this area.
Not a concern, though, for these locals, turning their street into a wet and wild. All this water is a result of Cyclone Jasper, which officially made landfall last night. It rolled over Woodjal Woodjal, around 170 kilometres north of Cairns at 8 p.m, bringing unrelenting rain and wild winds, ripping up trees and covering road and debris, all making for a sleepless night.
No sleep because you keep wondering, God, should I run now or what, you know? But it's a bit hard.
Carney packed up precious belongings this morning.
We've got to go.
Deciding she didn't want to risk staying at home.
You're evacuating?
Yeah, just for as long as I can, because I just don't feel safe where I am now.
It is really coming up, isn't it?
Oh, the rain. Fast, very fast, yeah.
We've seen 24-hour rainfall totals of about half a metre across far north Queensland. That is a very large volume of water. And that rain is continuing.
The highest rainfall was in the Daintree, 624 millimetres recorded in 24 hours at Yandil. Nearby Daiwan, 500 mils. Mossman, 434, just under 300 at Port Douglas, and Cairns Airport, 209.
We are still seeing this rainfall, and we could still see impacts from flooding.
Really pleasing to hear that we've had no reports of any serious injuries or loss of life through the event, but the event's not over.
And while Cyclone Jasper has now progressed across the coastline, he's still making his presence felt here in the tourism town of Port Douglas. Very large trees are still felled. This has a fence broken because of it from those destructive winds. We're still seeing branches down across roadways as well, so cars are having to dodge those as they drive around. We have seen council workers today working to remove those debris and removing some of those bits and pieces that have fallen as a result of Cyclone Jasper. And businesses have also been getting back to what they do best. The next big jobs here are restoring the power and the phone service to those who are still without. We know there is still a long way to go on this event. I'm told this recovery is more like a marathon than a sprint. Sharon?
All right, Sally. Sally Guyte there in Port Douglas.